don't you give up? Aren't you afraid?
I have always kept my word, and I shall keep my promise. Betal, you are coming with me.
All right. Have it your way. But, and you know my condition, you will have to listen to my story during our journey and not utter a single word. Or I'll fly back to my abode. Once upon a time, a Brahmin, a learned one called Keshava, lived in the town of Dharmasthala. He had a small family, his son, wife, and his beautiful daughter, Madhumati.
Oh, Madhumati, my beloved daughter, how time flies. My little kid has grown up into a beautiful young woman. Time has come for me to find a suitable match for her.
Would you care for some more rice, father?
No, dear. Thank you. Listen, son, what is your name?
Greetings, I'm Vaman.
I would like to meet your parents, Madhu. Would you take me to them?
I have some good news.
Oh, what a coincidence! I have some good news for you too.
Well, then you go first.
I finalized a match for Madhumalti. His name is Vaman and he is very handsome. His parents are also very nice and very happy with the match.
What? You should have consulted me before finalizing it. I have also finalized the match for her.
Oh, father, mother, it's good that both of you are at home. I have found a suitable match for Madhumalti. His name is Madhusudan and he's a very accomplished man. What's the matter? Aren't you happy?
All right, I've figured it out. Since it is Madhumalti whose life depends most on it, we will ask her to choose among the three boys. I will call all of them on an auspicious day.
I'm Madhu.
Please have a seat. Welcome to our home.
Doctor, fast!
It's too late. I'm sorry, she's no more.
The grieving grooms-to-be decide to collect the ashes of Madhumalti. Madhu performed the last rites. All three of them collected the ashes and went in different directions to spend the rest of their lives searching for peace. Vaman went to live on the banks of the river Yamuna, Madho to some other town, and Madhusudan to live with a sorcerer and his family. One day,
Om Chamundai Namaha, Om Namaha, Om Chamundai Namaha, Om Kali Durga Namaha, Om Chamundai 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 Namaha.
I told you not to play him. Come inside. Don't disturb your papa. Come. Come inside.
What have you done? Shame on you. You are inhuman. You killed your own son in rage. I'm ashamed of living with you.
With special chants written in this book of black magic, one can turn ashes again into a living individual.
Madhusudan proposed the idea of bringing Madhumalti back to life to Vaman and Madhu, and they readily agreed.
Their claims on marriage to Madhumalti. Finally, Madhumalti was asked to take a decision. Now you tell me, Vikram, whom did she finally choose to wed? If you know the correct answer and are keeping mum, I shall break your neck. Answer my question now, or...
Oh, she married Vaman.
Are you sure?
Of course I am. It's obvious. Madhusudan gave her a new life, so he was like a father to her. Madho performed her last rites, so he was like a son to her. It was only Vaman whom she could marry.
Bravo, Vikram! You are extremely intelligent. But why did you speak? You broke your silence. Bye-bye. Goodbye.
I shall not let you get away, you cunning spirit. Here I come, Betal. You can run, but you can't hide. I shall get you.
You again? Why don't you give up? Don't waste your time in these jungles. Go back and enjoy the luxuries of your palace.
I will not rest, Betal, until I've kept my word. So come with me, or else.
All right. Have it your way. But you know my conditions? You will have to listen to a story during our journey and not utter a single word, or I'll fly back to my abode. King Jwala Sen, the ruler of Ujjain, was addicted to gambling. One day he was gambling with the neighboring king and was losing heavily.
King Jwala Sen, you may never lose, but it seems today is not your day. Do accept your defeat.
It's true, I've never lost, and today too I shall not lose. I bet my kingdom against all that I've lost until now.
Impressive, King Jwala Sen. Here's your chance. Let's see if you win this time. I won! You lost your kingdom and now your whole kingdom is mine. I'm the new ruler of Ujjain. God! Throw this man out of my kingdom now!
King Jwala Sen lost his kingdom to the opponent and was thrown out of his kingdom immediately. He wandered for several days without eating anything in a forest. And one day...
Thank you. I have never seen you before. Who are you? You look tired and hungry.
I am King Jwala Sen.
So what do you want now?
I want to get my kingdom back. But right now I'm starving.
Don't worry, son. I'll get you something to eat.
The king, your holiness. I cannot eat in this.
He is King Jwala Sen, and he needs royal food and royal place to rest. Please arrange for his needs.
Yes, your holiness.
Where am I? There was a beautiful lady and a palace here. Where are they?
I created them with my supernatural powers to make you feel comfortable.
So are they gone forever?
Well, I can create it back with my magic mantra. With that mantra, I can get anything you want.
Will you give me that mantra?
Yes, why not? But to master that mantra, you have to remember it by heart and recite it continuously standing in water for a year.
Yes, I will. Please give me that mantra. Thank you, Your Holiness. With this, I can get back my kingdom.
I wish you good luck, King.
Thank you, Your Holiness. A year has passed, and I have done what I was told. I should use the mantra now and get back my kingdom.
What do you think, Vikram? What was the reason that the mantra did not work? Did the sage lie or was the mantra wrong?
Neither did the sage give him the wrong mantra, nor what he said about mastering it was a lie.
Then why didn't it work?
Jwala Sen couldn't master it, because although he was reciting the mantra, his mind was focused on the beautiful lady that embodied the luxuries of life. To master something and achieve what one wants, one has to concentrate and never lose focus.
Well said, Vikram. You are wise, but foolish and forgetful. You spoke and you broke your word. So here I go.
You cannot escape me, Betal. I shall get you. You cannot escape me, Betal. I shall get you.
Again? Why don't you give up? Don't waste your time in these jungles. Go back and enjoy the luxuries of your palace.
I will not rest, Betal, until I've kept my word. So come with me, or else.
All right. Have it your way. But you know my conditions? You will have to listen to a story during our journey and not utter a single word, or I'll fly back to my abode. King Samarjit ruled the kingdom of Malaidi. Being the king and eligible bachelor, his matchmaker Ram Gopal visited him often with countless proposals.
Your Majesty, there are many proposals for you, but this time I have a unique one and I'm very eager to present it, if I have your permission.
Go ahead, Ram Gopal. Speak what you have to say.
Your Majesty, there is a merchant Chandramani. He has a daughter, Manimala.
So, be clear, Ram Gopal.
Your Majesty, Manimala is the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. Her beauty and grace is matchless. And I feel she would just be a perfect queen of Maladeep and your wife.
All right. Let me inquire about her. Thank you.
It's my pleasure. I shall take your leave now, Your Majesty.
Called us, Your Majesty?
Oh yes. I want both of you to go to Merchant Chandramani's house, meet his daughter Manimala, and find out how suitable is she to be my wife. Then report back to me.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Isn't Manimala so beautiful?
Yes, you are right. But would she be suitable for our king?
Yes, why not? But why do you ask? You have any doubts?
Actually, Manimala is so beautiful that our king will always be occupied with her charm. And then ultimately it is our kingdom that will suffer.
I think you are right. If the king marries her, he will neglect our state in her company. So what shall we do?
I think we should hide the truth for the betterment of the kingdom. Your Majesty, we didn't find her attractive at all. In fact, quite ordinary. We do not think she is fit to be your wife.
All right. Now you may go and don't mention it to anyone.
Yes, Your Majesty.
That lady on the roof.
Your Majesty, she is the wife of the courtier Krishnanan. She is a merchant's daughter.
What is the name of that merchant?
Chandramani, Your Majesty.
Your Majesty, we didn't find her attractive at all. In fact, quite ordinary.
Your Majesty, courtier Krishnanand is seeking permission to see you.
Krishnanand? Send him in. Yes, Krishnanand. Tell me, what brings you here?
Your Majesty, I have learned from one of the ministers that you like Manimala. Your Majesty, I am your servant and I am willing to leave her if...
Stop it, Krishnanand. How dare you think that I will agree to such a proposal? She is your wife and you should protect her. How can I commit such a sin by marrying someone else's wife? I don't want to punish you for saying this, but now go away or else I will change my mind. You liars! Why did you lie about Manimala to me?
We agree that we lied. But we thought if Manimala became our queen, then you would always be busy in her company and neglect the matters of the state.
So, in the interest of the kingdom, we decided to lie to you, Your Majesty.
You two have committed a serious crime and shall be hanged for it.
Now tell me, Vikram, who committed a crime? Answer my question or I will break your head into pieces.
It was not the job of the maids to think what is right or wrong for the kingdom. They should have done what was told to them, but lied in the interest of the kingdom and the king. But the king was harsh in giving capital punishment to the maids just because he could not marry Manimala. His crime was bigger.
Well said, Vikram. You are wise, but foolish. And forgetful. You spoke and you broke your word. So here I go.
You cannot escape me, Betal. I shall get you.
aren't there any more stories left to be told?
Oh, there are plenty more. We still have a long way to go. But if you speak again, I will fly back to my abode. So listen to another story quietly. The ruler of Himachal Pradesh was King Jitwahan.
Jai Deva, Jai Deva, Jai Radha Krishna, Govardhana Giridhari, Jai Deva.
King Jitwahan, who was famous for his benevolence and for his charity work. He was a religious person loved by his subjects.
Long live King Jitwahan! Long live King Jitwahan! Long live King Jitwahan!
But his only son, Prince Agniwahan, was into all kinds of vices. He was into drinking liquor and gambling. He hated his father's benevolent nature and considered poor as untouchables. One day,
come, dear son. I'm glad you found some time for your father. We are discussing an important matter regarding the improvement of water storage facilities in our kingdom. Join us.
Get out! I want to speak alone to my father.
Agniwahan, are you threatening me?
I am warning you. Tomorrow morning when I'll take over the throne, you will leave for the forest. And if anyone including you tries to stop me or alter my plans, he will not be alive to see the next morning.
Jitwahan left for the forest and started meditating to attain peace of mind and soul.
Ugh.
Who are you, lady? And why are you crying?
I am in great sorrow, as I cannot save my son.
What happened to your son?
He was taken by a demon who will eat him tomorrow night, and I can't do anything.
What if the demon doesn't eat your son? I mean, what if he eats someone else?
How is it possible, Your Holiness? Who will sacrifice his life to save my sons? And asking for such a sacrifice is a sin too?
I'll make the sacrifice. Tomorrow, when the demon comes, I'll sacrifice my life and save your son's life for you. The demon will eat me and your son will be with you.
What are you saying, Your Holiness? I cannot allow you to sacrifice your life to save my sons. No, this is not right. Please leave us to our fate.
The old lady kept on refusing, but Jitwahan managed to change her mind. She agreed to him with a heavy heart.
Grant me salvation.
Now tell me, Vikram, what do you think about Jitwahan's sacrifice? Wasn't it selfless and the greatest sacrifice ever made?
Betal, what was so great in Jitwahan's sacrifice? I am not at all touched by the story or impressed by his sacrifice. In fact, it wasn't a sacrifice at all.
What are you saying? If it wasn't a sacrifice, what was it?
Jitwahan wanted to achieve salvation since he knew he had lived his life and had nothing else to achieve. So it was kind of a suicide. In fact, he had committed a serious crime against his people by making his wicked son the king. It would have been a real sacrifice if he would have finished off his son and his evil intentions to save his people's interests.
You're right, Vikram. You're wise but foolish and forgetful. You spoke and you breached my condition. So here I go. You again? Why don't you give up? Don't waste your time in these jungles. Go back and enjoy the luxuries of your palace.
I will not rest, Betal, until I've kept my word. So come with me or else.
All right. Have it your way. But you know my conditions? You will have to listen to a story during our journey and not utter a single word, or I'll fly back to my abode.
Let me tell you the story of two Brahmin brothers who lived with their father in the city of Magadha. Their father, being a very religious person, performed rituals for his clients. His sons were very talented. Ram, the elder brother, would touch or smell the earth. And could tell whether there was wealth hidden or water in it. Thus, he earned a lot of money by providing his service to the people. Sham, the younger brother, could tell the content in a sieve by smelling it. He was renowned for his judgment of women, and he could tell their qualities by looking at them.
Excuse me for disturbing you, but I have been sent by the king.
The king? Why? Is everything all right?
Oh, don't worry. It's good news. The king himself has offered your sons a job in his court. He wants them to join the court from tomorrow.
A job offer from the king? Wow! We are so fortunate.
We are. Tell the king we'll be present in the court tomorrow.
I'm Ram and this is my younger brother, Sham. We are grateful to you for giving us an opportunity to serve you.
Welcome, Ram and Sham. I have heard you two are talented. I need men like you.
It's my necklace.
You liar, this belongs to me.
No, you cheat.
What's the matter? Who are you?
Your Majesty, I'm Sadhumal, a merchant, and this necklace is mine. Your Majesty, I'm Sevakram. I'm a merchant too, and this necklace belongs to me. Shut up! You are a liar! It is my necklace! You shut up! You are a cheater! This necklace is mine!
Enough of your fight. I'll have you thrown in prison.
But your Majesty, this necklace...
Shut up, I said. Ram and Sham, I give you your first task. This is tricky. Can you solve this problem? Tell us who is the real owner of the necklace?
Sure, Your Highness. Can I see both of your hands? Firstly, I'm sure neither of these two gentlemen is a sandalwood trader.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Then I'm sorry to say, but both of you are lying as this necklace doesn't belong to either of you.
sandalwood is used by the royal family. And as this necklace smells like sandalwood, I'm sure it belongs to the royal family. And your majesty, I'm sure we have passed the test.
Yes, you have passed the test. These two are my men. I wanted to test whether you are really talented or not. I'm glad to have you two as my courtiers.
Bravo!
Very well done. Unbelievable!
The royal messenger of the king of Ujjain is entering the court.
Long live the king of Magad. Welcome to Magad. I'm eager to hear the message of the king of Ujjain.
O king of Magad, Ujjain and Magad have been rivals for many years. But now the king of Ujjain wants peace between the two neighbors and extends his hand of friendship.
That is wonderful news. We accept this offer of peace and would be sending our messengers to Ujjain soon. Let this day be the beginning of our friendship.
Long live the king of Magad.
Ram and Shyam, I doubt the sincerity of the king of Ujjain. I want you two to visit Ujjain and find out the intentions of the king. Find out whether we can rely on him.
Yes, your majesty. We shall leave immediately.
Welcome back, Ram and Shyam. What is the news from Ujjain? Tell me. Is the king sincere enough?
Your Majesty, the king of Ujjain is sincere in his efforts towards bringing peace and wants to be friends.
But your Majesty, he is not a trustworthy person, and so we would suggest you to be cautious of him and not rely on him completely.
Your Majesty, the King of Ujjain has sent a gift for you.
Wow, what a throne! It has jewels fitted in it. It's very precious. Wow!
What a precious gift! I want it to be placed in my room. It's marvelous. Truly a work of art.
Wait, Your Majesty. Your Majesty, I can see that there is a hair on it. I need your permission to examine it.
A hair? Whose hair? What are you talking about?
I will explain it later, Your Majesty. Guards, check the throne.
Let me see. Oh God, this is a metal wire, not a hair. And it's poisonous too.
Both the brothers were rewarded by the king. Now tell me, Vikram, who was more talented, Ram or Shyam? If you avoid answering my question, I will break your head into pieces.
Both of them were equally talented. But Ram was more intelligent as he could sense the hair without even touching or smelling the throne. So I think he had an edge over his brother.
Well said, Vikram. You are wise, but foolish and forgetful. You spoke and you broke your word. So here I go.
You cannot escape me, Betal. I shall get you.
Aren't there any more stories left to be told?
There are plenty more. But have you ever thought about why would a hermit need me and why he chose just you?
Well, he needs you for some ritual that will increase his spiritual powers and bring affluence to my kingdom.
Oh, is it? Vikram, you don't know anything. He needs me not to increase his spiritual powers, but his occult powers. He practices occult magic.
All right, forget it. Why don't you just tell me another story?
You won't believe me now, but soon you will. Perhaps the right time to tell you everything is not now. Anyway, let me tell you another story. Once upon a time on the island of Bali, there lived two merchants, Ratan and Madan. They were partners and very good friends.
Today was a nice day. The business was good too.
Yes. Not only was the business good, we met some interesting characters too. Remember that fat man with the tiny mustache? I first thought there was a fly sitting below his nose.
Yeah. Don't make me laugh. My stomach is aching. Let's sit for a while. Let's count how much money we made today. Then we'll share it equally, right?
Right. But first have some bread and honey. I know you must be hungry.
Oh yes, I'm actually very hungry. Crying.
My husband and I were passing through the forest when we were robbed.
Robbed? Are there robbers in this forest?
Yes, they killed my husband and I'm left alone now with no money.
Oh God, we are sorry for your husband. Now, what are you going to do? Do you have some place to go? I mean to your parents or your in-laws?
No, I am an orphan. We were just married, so I don't have anybody in this world now.
Don't worry, we'll help you.
How can we help her?
Well, we can give her some money.
But where will she go? She has no place to go to.
And we can't take her with us too. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless one of us marries her.
But who will marry her? And will she agree to it?
Let's ask her.
Look, we genuinely want to help you, but we can't take you with us unless, Madan, you tell her.
Since you have no place to go and you have all your life ahead of you, we suggest you remarry.
Remarry? But who would marry me?
One of us.
I'll write our names on two chits of paper and shuffle them. You can pick up a chit and whosoever's name is on it will marry you.
The chit had Madan's name, so the woman married Madan. A year later, the woman gave birth to a beautiful son. Madan was very happy, but soon after the baby's birth, Madan died. The woman after Madan's death went to Ratan and asked for a share in his property, which Ratan refused. The woman went to the king's court to appeal. King, after listening to the whole case, gave his judgment. Now tell me, Vikram, was the woman justified in her demand? And what did the king decide?
Madan and Ratan were partners when they met the woman, and they agreed to let the woman choose one of them for marriage. Thus, it means she had equal right on both of them. So, she was justified in her demand, and the king also gave the same judgment.
You are right, Vikram. But don't tighten your grip. I will not escape now. We have almost reached. But I am warning you again against the hermit. He is a wicked person. Be careful. If he asks you to bend before the sacrificial fire, he will sacrifice you too to increase his demonical powers.
The impossible.
Go in front of the fire, King Vikram, while I chant the mantras. It will bring prosperity to your kingdom. Betal, how could you forget me so fast? This is my real body. The hermit was my elder brother. He turned me into a demon as I was against his practice of occult.
You saved my life by warning me against the wicked hermit. Come with me to my kingdom. I'll make you a minister in my court.
I'm ready to come with you, King Vikram, but only on one condition.
I promise. I'll listen to your story without uttering a word.
Ha 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 ha.